Okay, hello everyone. I would like to welcome you on my presentation about OpenStack Kubernetes and SaltStack and how these tools can be used for complete deployment automation. So, few words about me. My name is Aleš Komárek and I am working at Mirantis as a cloud architect, and I used to be a PTL of OpenStack Salt project, basically which is the root of the project I would like to talk about today. So the project is named Salt Formulas or Salt Formula, and basically what we do, we have used SaltStack and we prepared some, let's say, scripts to deploy services. We have more than 140 services today that we can deploy using using the project. Basically, there are also official Salt formulas, but they weren't good enough for us because every formula looked different, had a different metadata model, and had a different structure. So basically, what we needed was some consistency across all the formulas. So we had set up some rules that we follow. So basically, we have consistent metadata model for each of the formulas, and this is helpful for defining some support services. I will talk about this a little later. So, and one of the most crucial concept is the service decomposition. Basically, each formula covers one service, and if the system needs more services, the new service is covered by the new formula. For example, when you have some web application, it happens that you also manage, let's say, SQL databases or Nginxes. Basically, we don't do this way. Each of these services has its own formula and takes care of itself. So basically, there are several areas in which we focus. So infrastructure services, so basic operating system setup, then we have support services, all databases, caches, message buses, application services, different kind of, this is like Python, Java applications, you can name like all the OpenStack services fall into this category. And then we have support for a lot of monitoring services, collectors, data storages, the aggregators. Also the CI/CD services, so we can build artifacts, deploy artifacts, and we can communicate with multiple cloud providers, virtualization providers, or container providers. So let's look briefly on how we define services. So basically, this code, so we support services to be able to run on multiple operating systems. Basically, we cover multiple Linux families, or we can even have the same service to be run, let's say, on Windows, on Linux, or on Mac. So we support multiple versions of the service running on the multiple versions of the operating systems. So basically, what you see on the right, so there is an example of a definition of some service. So in this case, it's a keep alive cluster, a keep alive service with one cluster defined. So you can see that we are passing some of the vital parameters, and basically this is the given structure of our metadata that we follow at every of the services. So that was the previous slide showed a normal virtual machine service. So this slide now presents how we can define a service as a container. Basically, we use, let's say, client roles to define these services. So basically, we are putting some other parameters than for the regular service, but it is enough to run it on the container platform. Basically, we support Docker Swarm, and Kubernetes. And now it is important to realize that the project, so basically you define your Kubernetes as well, and you define the payload of the Kubernetes in the same model. So this applies to the OpenStack. Basically, the Salt project, Salt Formula project, is at the core of the Merantis MCP platform. So basically, you can you define in the model your entire OpenStack control plane, hypervisors, and then you can also in the same model define the workload that runs on top of the OpenStack. Yeah. So basically. We can, the Salt project can talk to the multiple cloud providers. So when we set up OpenStack, then we can say that we want to run certain VMs on the OpenStack. So this is the definition how we basically provide a running instance on the OpenStack. So there are a lot of covered cloud solutions. The Salt project uses the Python cloud libcloud library, which provides the access to many vendors of the cloud providers. And in the new version of the Salt, there was added a support for Salt minimum proxies. It's a mechanism that allow you to wrap and control devices that cannot run the Python or the Salt agent natively. So basically, it reuses Python Napalm library, which can talk to multiple vendors. It supports Cisco network orchestration or the Junos. Okay, on the right side, then you can see how are the metadata for these types of remote devices. Yes. So one of the most strong features of the system are so-called support metadata. Basically, when your infrastructure is defined in a consistent way, you are able to define some services without just looking at the model. So we use this function to set up the monitoring. Basically, everything in the monitoring is model-driven, so you basically tailor the monitoring to fit exactly what you have installed on your system. When you install a new service, basically, you just have to rerun the state of the monitoring and the new service will appear in the monitoring. Basically, we cover the entire length of the monitoring, so from the collecting metadata, collecting metrics and the logs, to the storing of the logs. We have support for Graphite, InfluxDB, Prometheus, and then also to the some evaluations and visualizations. So basically, we have support for Grafana, and the Grafana also takes the metadata from the infrastructure, and so basically you generate your dashboards according to what you have defined in your infrastructure. We use this capability to generate documentation from the infrastructure. It's very helpful. You get very good insight of what you are running, what versions of the packages, and etc. Then we support IP table security rules and backupping. Yes, so everything, every service that has some state can be backed up, and we use the metadata model, so we know exactly what needs to be backed up and where the service is running. Yes, and to make our life easier, we have created custom heat salt resources. Basically, these resources help us integrate the salt stack into the OpenStack cloud. Basically, the salt key resource, it provides the registration of the newly spawned minion into the salt master. Then we have the salt metadata. Basically, we are able to classify the newly spawned node, tell what classes it uses, and give it some parameters. On this level, you can reuse the parameters that are that come from the OpenStack itself. Basically, you have the ability to get, let's say, floating IPs and stuff, and other data that was not known at the time of the launch of the stack. And the last is the salt pipeline. So basically, you are able to, upon the creating and destroying the node, you are able to call salt master with certain with a list of steps it should do. So basically, it can call or it can update your monitoring if you add a new node. So basically, it runs the state for the Prometheus or for the Grafana, and then when you destroy it, it cleans it up for you. Okay, so there are some important links for you. The first one is the most important, that's the documentation. Then the second one, this, it's a code for the formula, so everything is open source, Apache licensed, so you are welcome to contribute, yeah, so and make use of it, and if you want, and if you see something wrong, you can fix it and give it back to the community. And the last link is the Heat Salt resource that you can then you can use and install in your cloud. Okay, so this is all. Thank you for your attention. I don't know if there is time for questions. If not, you can reach me at the email. And yes. Currently, we are using like external node classifier. It's a reclass. It's you can find it in the documentation. It's there is an entire long chapter about how we structure our metadata, how we go from the, let's say, service level when you have metadata for individual pieces, then to, let's say, some system level which aggregates it to some functional blocks up to some cluster level, which basically is the deployment. So for that we use the reclass. It's an external classifier. It's a similar to Hiera, but not entirely.
So all of your existing 140 or so formulas rely on that.
Yes, but you can provide the metadata just the simple pillar. It does not matter. Yes, so. What do you mean exactly? You don't need Heat. It's just to give your lifecycle management, spin up nodes, and then everything else is salt. Yes.